The next song is When Sunny Gets Blue. This is Afternoon in Paris. One, two, three. Thank you.
Hi, Taylor. This is Dr. Jeff Kunkel here, recently retired jazz studies coordinator at Montclair State University in northern New Jersey. I'm a jazz pianist as well and composer, and it's my job to give a little video review of your performance for the National Jazz Festival submission. So we're going to start with Sunny Gets Blue. I'm going to keep it on in the background and speak to you a little bit during the music, much as we would if we were live at a festival, okay? So here we go. So a nice little introduction, makes sense relative to the tune. I don't mind you playing the first part up an octave. I was curious why you switched so quickly. Maybe complete a phrase in one range or the other. It's a pretty luxurious tempo. You play a little figure like that, bump, bah. It'd be really nice to have the drums and bass played along with you. Little hits, makes the trio look organized. Yeah, the locked hand stuff. I've listed this a few times now, actually, and the locked hand stuff is really nice. Usually also called the George Shearing voicings, and you play them really well. There it is again, little figure. I like the little figure in your arrangement, any figure, and have the bass and drums play it with you rhythmically. A nice fill with the two hands and leads right into the next phrase with the locked hands. Seemed like you got a little bit delayed rhythmically there, but it's okay. And maybe nice sequence. You pulled it out there. No, I wasn't sure at first that you wanted to go for that alternative melody. I'd be curious if you play this tune pretty much the same way each time you do it now, if this is kind of your arrangement. Here it feels to me like you want to hint a little bit at the double time feel, I'm sorry. I like that you improvise around the melody. And even there that you leave some space, which is fine. Yeah, and have, again, the bass and drums needs to feel that with you and crescendo together. Yeah, we've already established that you do the lock hands really well. And you come to your ending. And maybe, for example, just a small conclusion of one chord to the four chord, back to the one chord. Just a little, some kind of a coda on the piece. Okay, so Sunny Gets Blue really went well for you. It sounds to me like a tune that you know very well and have worked up a nice little arrangement of the melody on, and you bring it back toward the end too. So if you're working on your own, if you're working with a private instructor, bravo for that. You guys worked out a nice melodic contour for the tune. I feel like the solo section in there that you kept pretty brief is not really the main feature there. It's really about how you play the melody. And one way to make, I think, the soloing part a little more special would be at some point to try that double time feel over the groove and just make sure that of course you keep track of that. That can be a little bit difficult if when you're thinking about the 8/8 kind of thing. So it'd be just a nice change. And it seems like you have the chops to do it. You never hesitate to play some nice fills and things of that nature. So I think it'd be nice for you to complete this arrangement with maybe a little up tempo section. Of course, you don't have to. Another nice alternative might be to have the bass player play half a chorus, something of that nature, a short part of the tune, and then you come back and out it goes, So it just seemed to me we've kind of done a little bit more with it that allowed you to show off your abilities a little bit more there on that tune. But it's a nice tune and you play it well, and the bass and drums are really helping you out in a positive way. They're really doing a nice job for you in this piece, and therefore it made it a really nice performance. All right, I'm going to pause a sec while I get up the other piece on video, and we'll be right back. All right, here we go with Afternoon in Paris, a great choice. I'm cool with this tune starting right on it. A little intro of some sort would have been nice. Be a little pedal point thing, like the bridge of the tune. Yeah, nice, nice and relaxed. There's the locked hands again. Seems, I bet it must be something you're working on at this point. Pedal point here is a little awkward. Two and four is really where you want to go with the pedal point. Well, let's run that back a little bit, actually. Let's see if we can catch that pedal point thing again. Because we want to make sure that I want to hear you get that pedal in the right place. Unless you're for some reason purposely trying to do it on one and three, it's very traditionally done on two and four. I missed it. I apologize and going to try it again, actually. Well, I'm not having any luck at this. Going to do it again. Because I really think it's an important point. Sorry, I wasn't. Here we go. Two, four, two, four, boom, boom, two, four, instead of one and three. It's pretty, a little bit awkward on the one and three. And so it's something you want to work out. You might have meant to do it that way. I heard a little rhythmic glitch going into the bridge. Okay, and then you're finishing out the melody really nicely. A solo. It's Good. I like that you end your phrases on the ands of beats instead of always holding out a note. And once in a while, when you hold out a note, that works. Good. Left-hand voicings are coming along. And you use them pretty sparely, which is good. It's not too overplayed, constant banging and pounding of left-hand voicings. Work on smoothing them out. The idea, of course, move your hand as little as possible. Those A and B position, as Mark Levine calls them in the Jazz Piano Book. Yeah, I admire your ability to solo with the locked hands thing. That's why I'm guessing you are working on it specifically. Now we come back to some of the melody again. Yeah, I think, again, the tune was a little on the short side. Could have gone through with a complete solo chorus and maybe another half, then back on the bridge with the conclusion of the tune using the melody, okay? I can't lie. Perhaps you're really trying hard to follow the guidelines set forth by the audition process. But in any event, so Afternoon in Paris, excellent. You're developing a repertoire, and that's what it's about, to play trio piano or solo piano. It's a lot of work for jazz pianists in general. You got to work out a solo repertoire. You have to have a trio repertoire and be prepared if you do any duets or anything of that nature. So playing jazz piano is a lot of work all the time. And you, a young man, are off to a really fine start of it. I like that, if anything, that you underplay rather than overplay. You seldom play a lot of senseless fills or things that don't make any musical sense. Your phrases make a lot of sense musically. I would just love to see you keep on going with them and expanding that which you're playing. And, you know, to continue to work on variants and smoothing out your left-hand voicings. I hope I get to hear you in another year doing this again, that you'll submit again. And it would be really fun to hear you play again. So, yes, definitely enjoyed your submission for National Jazz Festival. These two great standards that now you have in the bag as repertoire for, you know, any group that you might want to work with. And, you know, of course, learn the chord progressions, work on the two-hand comping so that you can give your bass player some space and all that kind of good stuff that you need to do to make a complete trio arrangement out of it, all right? So I just urge you to continue. I don't hear anything that alarms me or concerns me. Really, only things I enjoy and that tell me that you're on the right path towards becoming a fine young jazz pianist. So keep up the good work, Taylor, and continued good luck to you. Thanks for your submission to National Jazz Festival this year.